Museum of African American History and Culture opens this weekend.
In Washington, D.C., President Barack Obama, Michelle Obama will be on hand for the dedication ceremony. It will take place at 10 a.m. on that day in preparation for the great.
Now, tomorrow, the National Museum of African American History and Culture will open to the public.
Stark contrast, scenes of civil unrest and protest in Charlotte is the official opening of the African American History and Culture Museum on the National Mall. It is the latest Smithsonian Museum here in Washington.
And of course, it includes a man without whose vision and passion and persistence we would not be here today, Mr. Lonnie Bunch.
What a grand and glorious day to open a museum that will not just tell of a people's journey, but also of a nation's story.
I'm Lonnie Bunch, the director of the National Museum of African American History and Culture, a museum that, though it's only been open for 3 months, nearly a million people have come to visit.
I'm here to just take in the experience and to speak through some of the spirits of my ancestors.
We are here in D.C. We're from Baltimore, Maryland. We're getting ready to go see the African American Museum, just know more about our history.
The goal of the museum is pretty simple, to craft a place that allows all of us who come in to understand how central the African American experience is to all of us.
I'm Maurice Jackson. I'm a professor of history and African American studies at Georgetown University in Washington, D.C. The museum, quite simply, is a panoramic view of the struggles of the African American people from the first day they came on these shores to the present, documenting the lives from Africa to slavery to freedom.
And it don't take no x-ray to see right through my smile. I know. I'll be on the go, and it ain't no drink out there that can numb my soul.
The majority of the museum is underground, which is also symbolism of the majority of our history is still being unearthed.
All we want to do is be free. All we want to do is take the chains off. All we want to do is break the chains off. All we want to do is.
The museum is important because so much of our history is often erased, that there are people and groups and systems that really seek to wipe us off the face of the earth, that there is no evidence of us being here, that there is no valuable contribution that we've made to this country.
African Americans who went, and when they came home, are they gone for two things? Double V for victory, victory abroad, victory at home.
But we will not only defend ourselves to the uttermost.
I play my enemies like a game of chess where I rest. No stress if you don't smoke cess. Less, I must confess, my destiny's manifest. In some vortex and sweats, I make tracks like I'm homeless. Rap orgies with order.
California Penal Code Section 1202 through 1227, and also the Second Amendment of the Constitution guarantees the citizen a right to bear arms on public property.
Believe me, frontin' niggas give me heebie-jeebies. So why you imitating Al Capone? I be Nina Simone and defecating
it
on your microphone.
It has a good element on the role of sports. And we look at Jackie Robinson and others, you see men and women who carried themselves with dignity in winning and losing and representing their country with the gold medals.
One of the most important things we do throughout the museum is hip-hop has a presence throughout. And that's important because it helps to tell recent stories and contemporary considerations.
The museum has a great cultural cornucopia of things. You start off at the top, and the most beautiful element is the Cadillac of Chuck Berry.
Dry your eyes never let up. Forgive but don't forget, girl, keep your head up. And when he tells you you ain't nothing, don't believe him. And if you can't learn to love you, you should leave him. Cause sister, you don't need. And I ain't trying to catch up, I just want.
My experience in there was overwhelming. I guess in the bottom part of it, it was very emotional.
My favorite floor was the fourth floor because it was all about music and I'm really big on music.
This museum is just wonderful. It's gonna take a week, a whole week to see every or more.
So I hope that that people recognize the tremendous monument this is to the sacrifices that a lot of folks made who weren't even really considered citizens in their own country.
Hey, yo, I remember Marvin Gaye used to sing to me. He had me feeling like black was the thing to be. And suddenly the kettle didn't